It has been going around for a while now, and despite all the controversy around it, we can't deny it is a good tool to use when learning a new language, especially for shy people who may not feel so comfortable speaking with other humans. So today I will show you how you can use it, prompts that may be beneficial, and the type of practice that you can do with it. I've only used Copilot and ChatGPT so far, so I will only show you those. And I'll use Korean as an example, because I still struggle a lot with speaking. So first, we have Copilot, which is honestly my preferred one when it comes to chat. Because whether you're asking for prompts or asking for information, the answers tend to be better in my opinion, which makes it a great choice for practicing reading conversations or even learning new vocabulary. Next is ChatGPT, the good old ChatGPT we all know. I don't use it much because despite Copilot, it's more restricted with its answers. And sometimes I even feel they are less natural. But when it comes to voice, one-on-one conversations go smoothly. You have good output and you can talk about literally anything at any time. Now let me show you some ways that you can make good use of them. For both of them, the chat version works the same, and some of the things that you can do are listed here. The real holy grail, though, is ChatGPT's voice feature. I actually tried this mode with Google Assistant some time ago, but it just didn't feel right. Let me show you how a Korean conversation would go with it, and everything it provides you from that conversation. Mind you, I didn't practice for this one, so you're going to see my bad Korean right away. But I'm going to try my best. K-인플루엔서 알아요?
네, K-인플루언서는 개인적으로 영향력을 행사하는 사람을 의미합니다. 일반적으로 소셜미디어를 통해 팔로워들과 소통하며 제품이나 서비스를 홍보하기도 합니다. 아, 유명한 K-인플루언서 중 관심 있는 분야가 있나요?
이달에 K-인플루엔서가 나한테 말해서 흥만 배웠죠. 그래서 흥 뭐예요?
흥은 한국어에서 실망하거나 무관심을 나타내는 감탄사예요. 누군가의 말이나 행동에 동의하지 않거나 관심이 없다는 표현으로 자주 사용됩니다. 아, 예를 들어 누군가가 재미없는 이야기를 하면 흥, 재미없어 라고 말할 수 있어요. 이해되시나요?
그래서 흥만 나는 흥만 해볼까요? 해볼까면 재미있어요?
아, 흥만 사용하면 다른 사람이 무관심하거나 불만스러운 느낌을 받을 수 있어요. 아, 상황에 맞게 사용하면 재미있을 수 있지만 자주 사용하면 상대방이 기분 나빠할 수도 있으니 조심해서 사용해보세요. 어떤 상황에서 사용해보고 싶으세요?
너를 한국어로 좋아요?
네, 저는 한국어로도 잘 이야기할 수 있어요. 한국어로 더 이야기해보고 싶으신가요?
네. 네.
Got it. Would you like to continue speaking in English or switch back to Korean?
한국어도 주세요.
알겠습니다. 한국어로 계속 이야기해요. 지금 배우고 싶은 한국어 표현이나 주제가 있으신가요?
아니다. 나는 아까 말해서 너를 한국어로 좋아요?
아, 이해했어요. 네, 저는 한국어를 좋아해요. 한국어의 매력은 다양하죠. 혹시 한국어를 배우면서 어떤 부분이 가장 흥미로우세요?
K-드라마?
드라마를 좋아하시나 봐요. 아, 한국 드라마는 정말 인기가 많죠. 혹시 좋아하는 한국 드라마나 추천해줄 드라마가 있나요?
챗GPT는 가야 돼요. 감사합니다. 정말 감사합니다.
별 말씀을요. 다음에도 궁금한 게 있으면 언제든지 여기 있을게요. 좋은 하루 보내세요.
Shows you the whole conversation you just had. So if you didn't understand some parts like I did, you can basically go back to this and try to translate it or try to find out words that may seem odd to you. So I think that's really a good idea. There are many ways that it can be used for good, and I think this is one of them. I know ChatGPT has some language tutor modes, but I haven't really used them yet. So this is more like a general way of using it. So I think the tutor mode wouldn't differ so much in its use. If you have other suggestions about prompts or modes that can be used, write them down in the comments so we can all check them out. Thank you for watching. See you next time.